WJSU.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to this edition of WJSU's Tiger Talk Tuesday. I'm Spencer McClenty. I'm along with Coach Kamajita, Jackson State head football coach. Thanks, Coach, for joining us today.
Well, thank you. I appreciate you inviting me to be on your show.
So, Coach, let's talk about the football season. The 2011 football season was definitely a success. 9-2, not exactly, I guess, what you all intended. You wanted to be undefeated, which every school wants to be at the beginning of the year.
Absolutely.
But you had a good season.
Well, I believe that we had a good season. As you said, you know, we really wanted to go undefeated, and, you know, we had a few we stumbled a couple times along the way, and we wish we can get those back, but we can. But the guys really, you know, after that last time we stumbled, they really fought hard to bounce back and set a record at 9-2. And you know, I'm happy for our seniors, for our university, and our fans that, you know, this team that had something special about it has done something that hasn't been done in a long time.
Well, let's start with the most recent game, the 19th annual Capital City Classic, Jackson State and Alcorn, and it wasn't much of a classic, Coach.
Well, I think it was a classic show we put on by some of our seniors. I was just really impressed with what I saw, you know, the play of Casey and, you know, Tillman and Wilder and Riley Renty. These guys are seniors going out, and I just thought they just put on a classic show for our fans. And you know the younger guys blocking and tackling the way they did, they wanted the seniors to go out on a high note. So in our locker room, it was considered, you know, a classic for those guys, and that's what it was all about, to send them out on a real good note.
Yeah, and let me say, it was a classic performance by Jackson State, 51-7 over Alcorn State. I mean, they got a young guy, so I'm sure they'll be working to get better as the years come. Let's talk about some of these players. As you said, 10 seniors are going to be leaving. Some really important seniors: Casey Terrio, Renty Rollins. Let's talk about some of those guys, Coach.
Well, you know, their guys are going to be well missed. Donovan Robinson on defense. You know, he's just, there's nothing like him. You know, he's a great ball player coming off that edge on defense. And, you know, and over the years, he just got smarter and smarter how the game is played. And he's going to be well missed. And then you got a Riley Renty who can catch the ball any way that's thrown at him, and along with a Wilder who, outstanding football player, can, you know, wide receiver. You know, these guys, and then you come back with Tillman, who ended his career on a real high note, caught some major, major passes yesterday, and picked up some rack yards after that. And you know, and of course Casey throwing the football to these guys. And you know, then you got T.D. Davis, who you know, ran the ball for us right here from Jackson. You know, tough football player, hung in there, sat out last season, came back and got his senior year in. And you know, I'm just proud of them all. You know, just listened to them talk the other night about their commitment and what they said to each other, and you know, about character and going out in the real world. You know, it was so heart, you know, heart touching. You know, to hear them and the words they had to say about finishing up their careers. And I'm proud of them all.
One guy in particular, you said Casey Terrio, and he has, five records now, and is tied for another record of Robert Kent, former Jackson State quarterback. He's definitely a special quarterback, one of the best. Is he one of the best that you've had as a coach?
There's no doubt about it. You know, I've had some good ones. Even when I got here, you know, we had Jimmy Oliver, Magic Man. And, you know, Jimmy took us all the way to the championship and did a fantastic job, you know, and now Casey walking in, doing the job that he's doing. He's one of the top, you know, quarterbacks that I've ever had. You know, he's just have a real knack for the game, a real competitor, you know, sees a lot on the field. You know, he's kind of having a coach on the field, you know, being able to direct traffic and do the things that need to be done. And he can run and he can throw, and you know, and he's got a good head on him. You know, I don't see his future stopping for a long time.
All right, Coach, well, I tell you what, we're going to take a short break, and we're going to come back, talk about more Jackson State football with head coach Rick Comegy. Back in a moment.
And now it's time for your JSU Academic Student Athlete of the Week.
Today we spotlight Armand Carter, defensive tackle for JSU football. Armand Carter was named to the 2010-2011 SWAC All-Academic Team, which recognizes student athletes with a 3.0 GPA or better. Carter is a sophomore from Jackson, Mississippi. He attended Murrah High School. That's Armand Carter, JSU defensive tackle, our Academic Student Athlete of the Week.
All right, everybody, welcome back to WJSU's Tiger Talk Tuesday. I'm Spencer McClinty, and joining me is JSU head football coach Rick Comegy. We were talking about some of the players, 10 seniors leaving from this year's team, had a great record, 9-2. Coach, how proud are you of your coaches, the coaching staff that have helped?
I couldn't be prouder. The guys have done an awful lot. They did a lot of legwork on campus, and then the time that we had to put in there with the guys, both coordinators made that sure that it was solid and brief and quick enough and yet still meaty enough to go into a game with, and that was special, and I was really pleased the way they worked. I mean, the guys, it was a team effort, and when I say team, considering the coach is part of the team, and I'm just very, very proud. We sit in the meetings, we didn't get a chance to meet a lot as much as we did in the past, but when we did meet, we got out of what we wanted to get out of it, and then tried to send that message on out to the guys, and they did tape on their own. A lot of times the players did, they did their own, things they did over in their own rooms to get together just to watch more film on the play, on the opponent, a lot of things like that when we couldn't meet with them. And, a lot of effort was given out and a lot of belief was given back and forth. The coaches believed in them and they believed in us, and it really worked.
Well, going back, and again, a 9-2 record, one of the best records Jackson State has had since going 10-2 back in 1996. Great winning percentage, I think an 88% winning percentage, one of the best the school has ever had. I mean, it was just an all-around great season. But again, you wanted to go undefeated, was unable to do it, 2 losses. Coach, what would you have done differently had you been able to go back and play those games again?
Well, I would just play them the same way, and just hopefully this time that some of the things that happened in those games would not have happened. And I think the kids came out each time to win those games, and the Alabama State game, if we could take that game back, we had about 3 or 4 tip balls that were intercepted, and they were catchable balls. If we could take that back, and if we could take back maybe the last second of the game against Grambling, where we could let the punt go and just let it roll, or got that play in and time enough where Casey had a shot at the end zone. If those two things, if we could take those two things back, I would love to. But we grew up, as men, and we grew up as, as people. Our character thickened, and it made us understand that along with the good comes the bad at times, and it's going to be that way in life. And we have to be able to move on with a humble attitude and not take it out on the innocent, and it just helps them grow as men to stay humble, to stay on the alert to things that life brings and be able to handle it in the same even keel as you would when you have success.
Well, Coach, that's great. JSU head football coach Rick Comegy joining us on WJSU's Tiger Talk Tuesday. Coach, we got a few moments left. What do you want to say to all the fans that come out and support this year?
It was probably a banner year. Willie Richardson used to say all the time, there's going to be a lot of people out there at that stadium. There's going to be a lot of people coming back watching that football team. And, you're never sure about that, but it was proven to me that they really love the football program. They love good, solid football. And I'm just very appreciative of how they supported the kids, myself, the team. And it was just so great. We got the best fans in the world.
All right. Well, we thank you, Coach, for joining us. Head football coach Rick Comegy. We appreciate your time, Coach.
Thank you.
All right, folks, this is WJSU's Tiger Talk Tuesday. We thank you for listening. We'll see you again next week, 7:50 a.m.
Thanks, Spencer. We hope you enjoyed Tiger Talk Tuesday with Spencer McClinty. In addition to Tiger Talk, you can catch Spencer Monday through Thursday during the 5 p.m. News Now update with local and national sports coverage. Up next, it's Jazzmatic Morning. Keep your dial set to Cool and Current, WJSU 88.5 FM.